All right, so hello everyone. My name is Sumit Chandel. I'm a developer advocate on the AdWords API. Today I'll be talking to you guys about the report service in v20.10.08, which is faster, better, and stronger than its v13 counterpart, as you'll soon see. Okay, so v13 report service, the way things were. So these are essentially the steps you follow to create your report. The first is you set up a report type, the columns, the aggregate type, the date ranges you want to cover, and whatnot. Next, you schedule the report. And once it's scheduled, then basically you pull for ready status. Now, if this is a cross-client report, it could take a few hours to come back. And even if it's for a single advertiser, it could still take a few minutes. So you do that for a bit, and then once it's ready, then you download the report and then filter as needed. So as I was mentioning, you couldn't filter beforehand. If there are certain campaigns that you cared about, you'd have to just get everything back and then filter on your own. All right, so in code, this is what V13 would look like when you're doing scheduling reports. You basically create the report, test name, application type, campaign status that you care about, and all that. You select the columns, start and end date. You validate the report job beforehand, of course. Finally, you schedule it. And then you wait for it to either succeed or fail. And if it succeeds, download the report. Pretty straightforward stuff, and I guess most of you are very familiar with this. Now let's look at reporting the v20.10.08 way. So the first step is the same. You set up your report type, the column, and the aggregate type, the same way you would for v13. The one difference here is that the report columns that you want to select, you have to make a request against the API to get those, and then select out of that set for which you care about. Next, in your report definition, you can filter the data, and we'll look at that, so you can set predicates on your report definition before sending it out. And then finally, you download the report synchronously using a GET request, rather than asynchronously and holding for the ready status. And we'll see how all of that works. So this is what a call would look like using a Java client library to get the various columns available based on the report type. In this case, it's a keywords performance report. This call would return these columns back. Pretty familiar stuff. So we've got the columns now in setting up our report definition. The next step is to set the predicates. So this is that new thing I was talking about, which lets you set the filters you care about before you even run the report and let our server do the filtering. So in the sample one, you're saying we're setting a predicate for an aggregate ID that we care about. In this case, the predicate operator is equal, so we want to be that exact aggregate ID. In the second sample below, that's a predicate for impressions. So basically we're sending a predicate for any campaigns that have a greater number of, impressions that are greater than or equal to 0. And then finally, the last step is to add the report definition. So once we've got the columns, once we've got the predicates that we care about for the filtering, the next step is to add the report. So the first two steps are very, very similar to V13. Create the report definition, set the report type, the date range. The selector, we've already prepared that just before and all the other steps. So we set the selector to the download format. And then finally, create the operations, set the operator to add, and then call mutate to add the report definition. Right, so the adding the report definition then, the changes are very similar to the whole v2009 concept of get and mutate calls. So that's just been converted over from the report service as well. So how do you run the report? You issue an HTTP GET request to a report URL. You can see it over there. Basically that URL with your report definition item appended to it. At the time that you make the GET request, that's when the report runs and returns. So there might be a question there. If you use v13 to reporting, you know that sometimes reports can take quite a while to return. So what if this GET request times out by the time before the report is ready? Well, with the new service, we've actually made a point of returning within that time frame, within the time frame of a GET request timeout. So that means you can look forward to getting your report data much faster. Another important note, in the GET request, you have to set the authorization header. So you can see there, we're setting the authorization header to Google login auth equals to your registered auth token. So the auth token is something we have already created by this point as you're using the service. You'd have to include it in the header here as you're making the request. That's just for added security so that no anonymous user could just go and hit that URL and download your report. So for when you're creating report definitions, you can actually set the date ranges for them. And these are the various enumerations that are available. So the idea here is that you add the report only once. So I create the report definition. Let's say I want to just cover the last 7 days. So it's a weekly report, so I'm going to cover the last 7 days. I create that report definition once, I've added it, and then every 7 days I'd have a cron job, for example, that would issue the GET request to the report URL, and then would get that report every 7 days. And again, every time I'm issuing the GET request, that's when that report is run, right? So then it'll cover the last 7 days and keep going forward that way. In case the cron job crashes one day or something, I need to run a one-off report, then you can create a new report definition with the same fields, set a custom date for the dates you might have missed, and then just run that after it's been added. So these are the various report types that are available in v2010.08. A lot of these look familiar. I think a few of them are new on the next slide here. So all stuff that is pretty straightforward and easy to understand there. You might have noticed that structured reports weren't listed there, whereas those exist in v13, right? The reason why those exist in v13 was because in v13, campaigns that had served zero impressions would not get returned in campaign reports, in campaign performance reports. So in v13, that's why we had structured reports, so that you could get all campaigns under an account, whether they served zero impressions or not, and then you'd have an idea of what their structure looked like. In v20.10.08, whether it serves zero impressions or more, all campaigns are returned in the return data, so you'll always get a view of the structure of the account and the campaigns under it. So that's why there are no more structure reports in v20.10.08. Okay, so one note about cross-plant reporting. It's not available in v20.10.08 yet, so cross-plant reporting is only available in v13 for now, and that's the reason why we'll keep report service in v13 around for a little longer. There are plans to, of course, have cross-client support available in v20.10.08. No specific timeline on when that's going to be available yet, but we're looking into that.